and welcome. Thank you for joining us from the Maximum City, Mumbai, where we are trying to find out what is that one mudda, what is that one issue that is Mumbai ka mudda in this election? What is that one issue which is going to make the Mumbaikar go out and press that button on the EVM? Button dabao, desh banao is a campaign that we have taken with full heart and zest at Network 18. And in Mumbai, there is a story where we need to all the more urge the Mumbaikar to go out, button dabao, desh banao, because across the six constituencies, ladies and gentlemen, Mumbai does not come out and vote in large numbers. 50% nikal gaya, bahut badi baat hai yaar Mumbai mein. And that should not be the case in the financial capital of the country. So what is going to make the Mumbaikar come out and vote? Why should the Mumbaikar come out and vote? Joining us this evening, a very, very august panel, along with our audience also, big round of applause. Aap log sab jaag jaiye, wake up. And as you applaud, let me also introduce Dr. Rajan Saxena, Indrani Malkani, Zafar Sureshwala, Mrinalini Deshmukh, and of course, Prahlad Kakkar. People who have achieved a lot in their respective spheres, people who carry a weight with their opinion or whose opinion carries weight, let's first ask them. Let's first ask the ladies. Let me start with Indrani Malkani. You are very closely associated with this cause of getting people to come out and vote. What are you doing this time, Indrani ji? You're working very closely with the Maharashtra CEO, I'm given to understand it. And what is it that is going to make the Mumbaikar feel, chalo abki baar kar dete hain vote?
The first thing I'm going to ask before you go to vote is, have you checked your name is on the electoral list? Because for months we had a summary revision, check your name, check your name, check your name. If your name is not on the electoral roll, you cannot vote. So first thing is, the finger points at us that it is our franchise, so we must make sure as a voter that our name is on the list. Having said that, as part of the system this time, the theme of this year's election is accessible elections. So to make it as easy as possible from the infrastructure point of view, from the transportation point of view of all kinds of voters, primarily also the people who are disabled, the PWDs. So in Mumbai, transportation, that is across India, no doubt. But in Mumbai, for the first time, is being rolled out wheelchair accessible taxis, which are being offered free to all the people who may need to be taken to the polling stations. Buses are also being deployed. Now, when the administration is coming forward, that is the Election Commission's administration is coming forward, ultimately, it is our duty, as much as we say it's a right, to go and vote. So, every Mumbaikar, if your name is on the list, you're a voter, go out and vote. We are there for you.
Let me ask you, Mrinalini ji, do you need an issue to vote, or should voting be the biggest issue?
No, of course, the voting should be the biggest issue, because that is a right that has been given to us. And I think we should exercise that right with a lot of diligence and with a lot of care. And one of the things is that we have to go out in large numbers and vote. And my one more suggestion which I may like to make is that please understand who your candidate is. Please understand whether the value system, what you want to espouse, is there with him or her, which is there. And that is the way, because normally in a parliament election, it is taken that these are local issues. It doesn't reach the parliament. It's not so. The MP is representing this constituency. And whatever are the people, there may be mediums through which you can, you know, have access to him. But it is very important to understand what is the, who is the MP, and what are the values that you are, you espouse, that you want the MP to sort of go ahead with.
Well, before I come to the gentleman, let's go to the audience. Aapke haath mein mic hai. Namaskar, aapka naam?
Maratha Khan.
Aapne vote kiya hai? Aap Mumbai mein rehte hain? इससे पहले भी वोट किया है?
हर बार वोट किया है हमारे.
क्यों वोट किया?
बस लोकतंत्र का भागीदार हूँ, उसमें मेरी भी राय होनी चाहिए कि मैं कौन से कैंडिडेट को चुनूँ मैं अपने कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी के लिए. इसके लिए मैंने हमेशा वोट किया है.
अच्छा, आपके पीछे देखिए कुछ यंगस्टर्स हैं, उनको पूछते हैं, जरा माइक उनको दीजिए. हाय, व्हाट्स योर नेम? रूमा. हाय, हैव यू वोटेड बिफोर, आर यू गोइंग टू वोट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम? यू गोइंग टू वोट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. आर यू गोइंग टू वोट, आर यू थिंकिंग वेदर और नॉट आई शुड वोट? You're going to vote. Are you aware of the candidates in your constituency?
Yeah.
Have you checked your name in the voter list?
Yeah.
Yes. So here's one diligent voter, Prahlad Kakkar. Are you happy?
My main target for voting is actually young people who have never voted before. And they don't really care, because the question that I get from them most of the time when I address them at various forums is that who's to vote for? They're all crooks. That's the what do you call feedback I get from young people. What are they doing for me? Mere liye kya hai? Hamara kya hoga kalya? You know, that is the whole attitude.
Let's ask if there's anybody here jiska aisa attitude. Is there anybody who agrees, who feels similar to Prahlad Kakkar? You feel that way. You feel. Why do you feel that way? Let's get the bike across to him. Yeah. Why do you feel that way?
No, because as far as town people are concerned, whoever comes is busy trying to get people from the slums to do what they want. They're not interested in what we want. Last year also people came, made promises, nothing was done in 5 years. Also we have this fix that we have one candidate who comes from a very good party and the other candidate is very good, but his party is not so good as of today. So it's a real fix here.
And now what do you do? How do you fix this, Zafar Sareshwala? Party is good, candidate is not. Candidate is good, party is not. Town people think, "Are you're working for people in the slums. Hum townies ka kya hoga?" What? This is a very Mumbaikar feeling.
I'll tell you what Prahlad ji also said and the lady said. It's not only right. It is right. Yes, that constitution has given, but it is also our duty. As a citizen, it is our duty. In fact, it is more than the right. And if we don't exercise this duty, and why people don't exercise, as he rightly pointed out, ये dialogue हमेशा सुनने मिलता है, यार कौन आएगा, चोर का भाई घंटी चोर, तो क्या करेंगे हम? But this is, and this has gone to that level. But if citizens don't vote, because you get once in 5 years that chance, so it is the duty of you voters and within yourself to create a pressure group. There should be some mechanism that in particular constituency, there should be a group, which group meets him all the time and wakes him up. So actually he sleeps because we also sleep.
Correct.
Because we think that on such and such date, I have just completed my right and that duty does not take up.
Zafar
so it is our duty to continue with that.
Yeah, Zafar Sareshwala says that the process begins from the time you cast the vote. It doesn't end after you cast the vote. It actually begins from the time you cast the vote.
I have different perception for this. Basically, when we vote, we get the right to ask the question to the candidate. I have voted you and you have not done my work. So I am your voter. I have given my time, my biggest fundamental right given by our Constitution of India. So I have full right to ask you the question, ki what are the issues in our area? You have not done this. So I am going to vote for that reason, because I will ask the question and he will be answerable for me.
Exactly.
No matter of which party. No doubt I am going to see who is the candidate, what's his character, how he has worked in the past, what's his social achievement. No doubt. As an educated person, I'm going to find out and I'm going to educate the person in people in our area ki who is right for our people.
Right.
So it's a fundamental right to ask the question to the
government. Fundamental right. So you get the right to ask.
You need to start this, because why the candidate sleeps? He knows kab 5 saal ke baad mujhe aana hai. Mera prime minister kaam kar raha hai. Mujhe kya karna hai? So it is our duty that you wake him up. I've seen this in England. In truest term, I've seen that member of parliament and the voter thinks that he's the government, he is my servant. That is the attitude. You should bring that candidate of yours, once he is elected, that you are there because of me, not in spite of me.
Simple thing. Just tag these netas on Twitter, say, 10 bar phone mara, tumne phone nahi uthaya. Fir troll karna shuru karo. Then automatically unke office se phone aana shuru ho jayega. And that, like Zafar Sareshwala said, form an organization or an association. The association secretary or your WhatsApp group head, admin, is the person who's the point person with his MP's office. If the MP's office does not respond, tag the MP and put it out on social media. Today, that is the biggest advantage for us as citizens, to make them accountable on a social platform. Because they have to respond. Because if they don't respond, you'll plaster it there. Vote diya, baat nahi kiya. Vote diya, baat nahi kiya. I'm just going to ask the Vice Chancellor of NMIMS, Dr. Rajan Saxena. Sir, this time around, tell the students, the day after the polling, when they walk into the class, sabka ungli check karenge.
I think in the first place, if I want a government that is going to be functioning, then it is my responsibility to vote a representative accordingly.
Correct.
And secondly, one of the biggest kind of a issue that we as Mumbaikars always face is a whole issue of infrastructure and several other kind of, you know, gaps that we see in the city itself. And every time that we talk about the infrastructure or various other gaps, we just turn around and criticize the government.
Yeah.
I think if we do not elect properly our representative, then I think as a citizen and as a Mumbaiker, we have no business to be criticizing what we have today.
Exactly. So this is this check.
Precisely what I told the students for the last 4 years. Last year, they came out and voted. I said, if you think that it's a holiday and you can go and sleep late and that your vote doesn't matter, you don't have the right to complain.
Absolutely.
Only if you vote do you have the right to complain. Shut up if you don't vote.
Absolutely, absolutely.
I
have to take
honestly, before you go, Anand, if I may,
yeah.
That this time, the Election Commission site, if people, because everyone is tech savvy, right?
Yeah.
That about the affidavits, who is your candidate, everything is out in the open.
Yes, it is.
So transparency is at its height. So it is really foolish on our part if you don't take advantage of that.
Simple search, candidates of Mumbai
absolutely.
North. Mumbai North Central, Mumbai South, Mumbai South Central. You just need to search and you have all the information. And then uska pura biodata hai, candidate ka. And then you say, isko dekha lagta hai, kabhi nahi dekha lagta hai. Then you decide, karna hai ki nahi karna. But button dabana. We take a very, very short break. When we come back, it's from the Janta back into the panel on Button Dabao Desh Banao. Stay with us. Desh Banao, and I'm standing right next to two or three gentlemen who wanted to air their views. And the lady on the other side, we'll go to her after that. Yes, go ahead, please.
My name is Kamlakar Shenoy. I have been an alert citizen of Mumbai and have filed several PILs on roads, bridges, housing, as well as police working also. The problem with the politicians is they do not want to interact with people like us. I know all the MPs personally and they know I work very hard. They appreciate me in private, but when I ask them, come on, we'll have a debate on the stage, no person wants to have a debate with me. And in fact, during the elections, my request is that we should pursue the political parties whenever they are calling for a meeting in the public. One of our activists should be there on the stage and they should answer our questions rather than they telling what they have done, which mostly is incorrect or bogus.
So, ab baat nota pe aati hai. What if I look at the nota option? So, Zafar Sareshwala, Indrani ji have an opinion. I'm going to start with Indrani and then Zafar.
Yes. Yeah. So, that is the point. When you go to press the button, it's not telling you which button to press. So, if you don't like your candidates, go press the nota. The idea is you must exercise your duty to go and press the button. So now nota, I know there's a lot of questions are asked that nota really has no,
significance,
significance because it is not counted, etc. Because our system is first by the post.
Yeah.
So, but when if nota becomes a talking point, if it happens,
once it reaches a critical mass,
I'm sure that at some point the it is there in the pipeline for the reform.
No, but the counter argument is that nota should be backed with the right to reject.
That is correct.
But so the fact is right now you don't have a right to reject, so nota actually becomes ineffective because in the recent elections you've seen nota take at least 2 to 3% votes.
Correct.
And in certain cases nota polled higher percentages than the candidate that turned up number third or number second.
You're absolutely right.
Yes, Zafar.
I'll tell you again, I'll continue with the duty part
And
what you also said. We need to organize in that. That's why I'm saying that your job starts after you dabao the button.
Correct.
Hum samajhte hain ki khatam ho gaya. Nahin. वहां से शुरुआत है और आप अकेलों से नहीं होगा
या
आपको एक ग्रुप बनाना पड़ेगा आप ग्रुप बनाओ और देखिए आजकल तो ट्विटर ऐसी जबरदस्त चीज है व्हाट्सएप ऐसी जबरदस्त चीज है कि अच्छे अच्छों के पानी निकल जाते हैं अरे भाई रेलवे मंत्री ट्विटर पे भेजता है कि देखो फला मेरे जा रहे हैं और वो कोई घुस गया है फौरन हो जाता है
हाँ।
तो वो जमाना अब चला गया है
करेक्ट
अब शेमिंग एंड नेमिंग है अब हमारी जो ड्यूटी वाला जो काम है वो आपको शुरू करना पड़ेगा लेकिन ऑर्गेनाइज वे में दूसरा नोटा की जो बात है
व्हाट्सएप के लिए भी बटन दबाना पड़ेगा
बिल्कुल अब वो बटन दबाना है वो आपको वो बटन शुरू कर देना है ट्विटर का भी और व्हाट्सएप का भी एक बात जो नोटा वाली है देखिए नोटा से क्या होगा ये तो बहुत आसान है आप इनको तय करो इनको कहो कि देखो हम तुमको बिठा रहे हैं यहां पर ये हमारी वो रहेगी आज हमने तुमको यहां बिठाया है अब हम आपसे सवाल देंगे तो वो काम हम नहीं करते
राइट
और आप जैसे अकेलों का नहीं होगा आपको लोगों को जमा करना पड़ेगा एक ऑर्गेनाइज प्रेशर ग्रुप होगा आप देखो ये जिस दिन आपने कर लिया तो ये मंत्री साहब और एमपी साहब आपको बुलाएंगे आपको नहीं जाना पड़ेगा
प्रहलाद का
ससून डॉक्स में जो हैं आप अकेले नहीं हैं पूरी आपकी कम्युनिटी है पूरी फिशिंग कम्युनिटी है, मच्छीमार की कम्युनिटी है, लेडीज लोग की कम्युनिटी है जो जो सौदा करती है, जो जो एक्चुअली मच्छी धंधा करती हैं, अगर वो एक साथ मिल जाएं और जिस कैंडिडेट को बोले देखो भैया आपको हम वोट देने वाले हैं और आपको इसलिए वोट देने वाले हैं कि ये काम हमारे करने हैं।
सो वन ऑफ द मेजर कंसर्न वेयर आवर पॉलिटिशियंस और प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट हैज नॉट डिलीवर्ड इज क्लाइमेट चेंज एनवायरमेंट एंड राइट नाउ इन मुंबई ऑल्सो वी कैन सी दैट सो मेनी सिटीजन्स ग्रुप आर फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ आर ए फॉरेस्ट और कोस्टल रोड दैट इज डिस्ट्रॉइंग द कोस्ट, बुलेट ट्रेन इज ऑल्सो डिस्ट्रॉइंग फ्लेमिंगो सेंचुरी एंड इन द एंटायर वर्ल्ड नाउ इवन स्कूल स्टूडेंट्स आर कमिंग आउट एंड दे आर रेजिंग देयर वॉइस अगेंस्ट क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड दे आर डिमांडिंग गवर्नमेंट टू टेक एक्शन. सो एज यू राइटली सेड सर इज दैट वी नीड टू क्रिएट प्रेशर on the system and that is only when system will work. So I would like to you know also hear about their opinion because present ruling government also has you know mentioned very little or the party very little about environment issues in their manifesto. So should it be a point of concern of the
should,
citizens?
Should environment become a concern for the Mumbaiker to come out and vote?
There's one aspect that's completely missing at this point of time, and that's where the disconnect comes about.
Yeah.
My mind. अब वो है जबकि नेता केवल स्टेज पे खड़े होके एक भीड़ के अंदर अपना भाषण देकर और फिर सबको नमस्कार करके निकल जाता है. कोई कनेक्ट नहीं है, कोई हमारा कोई बातचीत नहीं है किसी भी तरीके से. जब तक हम उसको नेता को या कैंडिडेट को एक डायलॉग के उसमें नहीं लेकर आते हैं, एक डिस्कशन फोरम पे नहीं लेकर आते हैं जैसे कि कहा गया, तब तक कोई भी नेता जिम्मेदारी महसूस नहीं करेगा.
आई एग्री विद यू सर, आई एग्री विद यू, बट वी ऑल्सो नीड टू एज वोटर्स अंडरस्टैंड दैट लोकल लेवल इश्यूज आर सिविक बॉडी इश्यूज, देन यू हैव एट द म्युनिसिपल लेवल, देन यू हैव द स्टेट लेवल इश्यूज एट द असेंबली लेवल विच इज द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग टू डू, एंड व्हेन यू गो आउट टू वोट एट अ नेशनल लेवल, you as a Mumbaiker, you as a person living in a particular constituency or city has to also see what is the dynamic nationally that is going to affect me locally, and that is the consideration.
Absolutely.
So if you start mixing up these issues, because you, how many of the voters have actually gone out and voted in civic polls? Municipal polls mein if you have not cast your ballot, can you ask your MP a question when you have not bothered to choose your corporator? Can you ask your minister, your MLA a question when you have not bothered to go and vote for that MLA? At every level, you have to understand which issue is going to be sorted at what level and who's going to be able to do what. So a central policy decision, is that going to be decided?
But
you're saying they're all interconnected, they cannot be isolated.
No, many of these issues.
No, I'll tell you, yes. Yeah. Yes, coming to that point, yes.
Final minute, sir.
इंटेलिजेंस वी नीड टू हैव कि कौन सा सवाल किसको पूछना चाहिए.
yeah.
हमारा प्रॉब्लम यह है कि म्यूनिसपालिटी का सवाल एमपी को पूछते हैं.
right.
तो हमको ये हेरार्की में तीनों को, और आपकी जो बात है कि भाई इशू यह है कि हमने सुना था कि मुंबई को शंघाई बनाने वाले हैं.
है.
तो मेरी इतनी इल्तिजा है कि आप लोग इनको प्रेशर डालिए कि भाई मुंबई को मुंबई तो बनाओ.
And Mumbai ka mudda uthana is going to be the responsibility of those who go out and vote. The serious check has to be, if you have not gone out to vote, then A, vote nahi kiya. You need to shame those people. Second, next time don't ask a question. Don't crib, don't ask a question, don't complain. Because first question to be asked of you is, vote kiya gaya? Kiya to kidhar kiya? Constituency bata, poll number bata, booth number bata, candidate bata. Because unless you give those details, unless you button dabao, you cannot question about desh ban raha hai, desh nahi ban raha hai. Mujhe ye chahiye, mujhe wo chahiye. Because you have not exercised what is your, not just your right, but also your duty towards this country. I have to wind up at this point. We'll continue the series of button dabao, desh banao here on Network 18. Thank you. Thank you to everyone. Big round of applause to everyone, please. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.